Very good morning, children. Welcome to the psychology classroom. So, how are you all? I hope you all are fit and fine and working toward your studies, which is very important for you all. Firstly, I should mention the details. I hope the date is visible to you all. So today is 8/12/21, class 11C. Subject psychology. So details are properly visible. Okay. डिटेल्स आपको प्रॉपरली विजिबल हैं. ओके, सो चिल्ड्रेन, ऑब्वियसली वी आर डूइंग द क्विज, सो आई शुड राइट डाउन ओवर हियर रिवीजन. द टॉपिक विच वी आर स्टडिंग और द चैप्टर विच वी आर डूइंग रिवीजन इज चैप्टर 3, द basis of human behavior. This is our chapter name. You noted down this chapter name in your copy. If you have seen the yesterday video, you might have noticed that the topic which I discussed lastly is about the cerebrum and the lobes. So basically, I am discussing with you the nervous system. So I told you all that our nervous system is divided into two parts, central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Where central nervous system I discussed with you, so today we are going to discuss about the peripheral nervous system. Nervous system. The full form is PNS. So I hope you all have written the topic peripheral nervous system, PNS. PNS is divided into two parts. One is SNS, which is somatic nervous system. Somatic nervous system.
nervous system.
Somatic autonomic. Firstly, we discuss about somatic nervous system. It is that system, somatic nervous system. So, it is that system, which work voluntarily. On the other hand, autonomic nervous system is a system which work involuntarily. Means it is something, a system which is not under the control of the organism. It works involuntarily, autonomic, automatic होता है. And somatic, which work voluntarily, which we do by our own choice and which is completely under the control of the organism. When we are talking about somatic nervous system, so it is divided into two parts, that is spinal nerve. Some nerves are found in this spinal nerves and cranial nerve. Cranial nerve are of 12 set of pairs and spinal nerve are of 31 set of pairs. So this is a question which is maximum time asked in the objective type questions, that how many pairs are there in cranial nerves and the spinal nerve. So please note down these points which I had written on the board. So I just hope you all have written it down. Now we are going to discuss about autonomic nervous system. This is again divided into two parts, that is SNS and PNS. The full form of SNS is sympathetic nervous system, and this full form is parasympathetic nervous system. Sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. The ANS is divided into two parts, sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. Okay. Now, what is the difference between these two nervous systems, sympathetic and parasympathetic? Sympathetic nervous system is a situation which deal with the emergency. It is something related to the fight and flight mode. लड़ो या भागो. ओके, इमरजेंसी सिचुएशन में ये डील करता है. व्हेन देयर इज एनी काइंड ऑफ इमरजेंसी हैपन, सो सिंपैथेटिक नर्वस सिस्टम गेट एक्टिवेटेड. ऑन द अदर हैंड, द फंक्शन ऑफ द पैरासिंपैथेटिक नर्वस सिस्टम इज जस्ट अपोजिट टू द सिंपैथेटिक नर्वस सिस्टम. इन पैरासिंपैथेटिक नर्वस सिस्टम इट मेक्स द बॉडी calm down, relax. Due to the sympathetic nervous system, whatever the things which are get accelerated in our body, like heartbeat increases, body temperature up and down, pupil dilates, okay, so everything it come into the normal position. When the parasympathetic nervous system activated. So parasympathetic nervous system is a system which deal with the person, making the person calm down. Okay, please note down this point also. Okay. I hope you all have written this one. Now separately we are going to discuss one by one. The first is sympathetic. Nervous system. Sympathetic nervous system deals with the emergency situation. Sympathetic nervous system deals with the emergency situation. Many of the bodily changes take place, like heartbeat increases, pupils dilate, blood pressure increases, etc. So these are mentioned, which are mentioned over here. These are some of the points, but there can be more than these things. If you see in your book, there is a diagram which representing the autonomic nervous system. Here you will find out sympathetic function and parasympathetic function. What is the function of the sympathetic and what does the function of the parasympathetic? Please note down this one. Sympathetic nervous system. So I hope you all have written it down. Now we are going to discuss about parasympathetic nervous system. Okay, let's discuss about the second part, which is parasympathetic nervous system. Now this function opposing to the sympathetic nervous system, it made the person calm and quiet. It makes the person calm and quiet. It is the system which restore energy. Energy conservation ka jo function hota hai, that was done by the parasympathetic. Sympathetic nervous system mein jo bhi aapke body ki energy ko lost kiya hai, usko conserve karna, usko fir se restore karna, making the body in bringing the body into a normal position, all these functions were done by parasympathetic. So it is the system which bring the body in a normal position. Which brings the body in a normal position and restore the energy. And restore the energy. Please write down these points also. So this is the function of the parasympathetic nervous system. So today in this video, I discuss with you the peripheral nervous system. Okay? I hope you all have written it down. So basically, from this chapter, I discuss with you central nervous system, peripheral nervous system. So that part we have covered. Now the next system which govern your basis of human behavior, the biological basis, is endocrine system. Yes, children. When I started this chapter revision, I already told to you the two parts, the two system which play a greater role in shaping the human behavior. And not only in shaping the human behavior, but also making the biological basis of human behavior. And that two part is nervous system and endocrine system. Hormones play a greater role in shaping the human behavior. Due to these hormonal changes, the people behaviors found to be changed. Okay? So let's study about the endocrine system. Here in this system, you have to discuss about, we have to discuss about endocrine glands. Endocrine glands are found to be ductless gland. They are without the ducts, so they are called ductless gland. Okay, these are known as ductless gland, endocrine gland. There are so many endocrine glands. First is pituitary gland, which is also known as master gland. इसे हम मास्टर ग्लैंड भी कहते हैं. Why is it called as master gland? इसे master gland क्यों कहा जाता है? Because it is because of its location. Every gland is located in your body somewhere, and it is located in the brain, and that is why it is known as the master gland. Now next part, after the pituitary gland is thyroid gland. Then third is adrenal gland. Then fourth is pancreas. And fifth is gonads. So five glands are there, which are discussed in this under the endocrine system. Pituitary gland is situated in the brain, and that is why it is also known as master gland, and it secretes hormones so every gland secretes different kind of hormones. Second is the thyroid gland. It is situated in the neck, and the hormone which it secretes is thyroxine. Overproduction of thyroxine and underproduction of thyroxine both are harmful. If thyroxine is produced more in your body, that can be also harmful. And if it is not produced, also under production, that is also harmful. Adrenal gland. This is the third gland which is situated on the top of the kidney. Kidney ke top pe ye situated hote hain ye gland, or it looks like just like a hat of the kidney. Okay. They also secretes hormones. And it is also divided into two parts, adrenal medulla and adrenal cortex. Both of the adrenal gland release different kind of hormone. Pancreas. It secretes the hormone insulin. Gonads are known to be the sex gland. Ovaries are found in the females and testes are in the male. Different hormones secreted by the ovaries and the testes. So discussion about this system, I will going to discuss with you in the next video in very detail. Today I had given you some of the brief of this one. So whatever the things I had discussed with you today in this video, I hope you understand it. Still, if you have any doubt, you discuss in the classroom, children. Okay, thank you so much, children, for carefully listening.